सभासद माननीय उपसभापति जी।
Let me dispose this. I will allow you. Sit down. Let me dispose this. Let me dispose this. ये formal business करने दो, उसके बाद ना papers भी laid on the table. श्री Jewel Oram.
Sir, I beg to lay on the table of the house the paper listed against my name at serial number 1 in the today's revised list of business.
Sri Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi.
Sir, on behalf of my colleague Sri Bandaru Dattatreya, I rise to lay on the table of the house the paper listed against his name at serial number 2 in the revised list of the business.
Sri Dharmendra Pradhan.
Sir, with your permission, I rise to lay on the table of the house the papers mentioned against my name at serial number 3 in today's revised list of business.
Srimati Nirmala Sitharaman.
Sir, with your permission, I wish to lay on the table of the house papers listed against my name in item number 4 in revised list of business for today.
Dr. Mahesh Sharma.
Sir, with your permission, I rise to lay on the table of the house the papers mentioned against my name at serial number 5 in today's revised list of business.
Now, message from the Lok Sabha.
Sir, I beg to report that the Lok Sabha at its sitting held on the 28th March 2017 passed the National Institute of Technology, Science, Education and Research Amendment Bill 2017. I lay a copy of the bill on the table.
Statement by Minister Sri Haribhai Pradibhai Chaudhary.
Sir, with your kind permission, I rise to make a statement regarding the status of implementation of recommendation of 271st report of the Parliamentary Standing Committee on Industry. On the recommendation observation contained in its report on demand for grant 1516 pertaining to Ministry of MSME.
Thank you. Let me listen to that point of order. Okay. I'll call you. I will give you a chance. आपको बुलाएगा. आपको बुलाएगा. लेकिन वो point of order है. वो point of order है. सुनने दो. Point of order सुनने दो. बोलिए बोलिए.
Sir, sir, सदन के.
Let me listen to the point of order. I will call you. Sit down. Let me listen to point of order.
Sir, सदन के कार्य संचालक विषयक नियमावली में तीन चैप्टर 12, 13 और 14 ये सदस्यों को व्यक्तिगत रूप से अपने विषयों को लोकहित के विषयों को उठाने के लिए चैप्टर 12 सर 267 के बारे में बोल रहा हूँ सर लेकिन चैप्टर 12 13 और 14 सर
ओके
शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन के लिए कॉलिंग अटेंशन के लिए लोकहित के विषयों को उठाने के लिए सदस्यों को इंडिविजुअल राइट है सर और सभी सदस्यों को लोकहित के विषय उठाने भी चाहिए सर लेकिन सर हाउस का काम सस्पेंड करना ये कलेक्टिव विजडम होना चाहिए इसलिए मेरा ये सुझाव है कि 267 में अमेंडमेंट किया जाना चाहिए कम से कम 10 सदस्य या 10% सर
दैट इज योर पॉइंट ऑफ ऑर्डर ओके
सर ओके सर ये इंडिविजुअल राइट नहीं होना चाहिए
या
सर हाउस का काम
पॉइंट ऑफ सी
सर ये इंडिविजुअल नहीं होना चाहिए
यस
हम सबको कंसेंसस
दैट इज ए
कंसेंसस बना के कर
नो नो दैट इज अ सजेशन Now, Bhupendra Yadav ji, Bhupendra Yadav ji, that is a suggestion for amending the rules. You can proceed if you would like. I have no objection, but I have to go by the existing rules.
Sir, Sansadiya
Mantri. No.
Sir, that is not.
I have to go by. No.
Sansadiya
Mantri. No. That is only a suggestion. Now, yes, Ram Gopal Yadav ji, I'll call you. राम गोपाल यादव जी यस
आपके द्वारा होना चाहिए और रूल्स उसमें जो है इजाजत देने चाहिए
देयर इज नो पॉइंट ऑफ ऑर्डर इन दैट दैट इज ओनली अ सजेशन दैट्स अ सजेशन नाउ दैट्स ओनली नो प्लीज दैट्स ओनली अ सजेशन एंड बट हाउएवर नो हाउएवर इफ द मेंबर वांट्स ही कैन प्रोसीड विद दैट ही कैन write for the taking steps for the amendment of the rules I have no problem in that but I have to go yeah that's what I am saying Yes, yeah. Rules committee will to do that. Now, yes, Ram Gopal ji. राम गोपाल जी ये ठीक है आपने दिया है 267 लेकिन
इसमें चर्चा कराने के लिए टाइम तो
आप सुनिए ओके आई अंडरस्टूड आप ठीक है अभी सुनिए आपने 267 नोटिस दिया है चर्चा के लिए डिमांड टू डिस्कस सिचुएशन ड्यू टू नॉन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ एससी एसटी कमीशन माइनॉरिटी कमीशन बैकवर्ड कमीशन आपने दिया है लेट मी कंप्लीट दिस सब्जेक्ट दिस 267 यू हैड गिवन एस्टरडे आल्सो यू हैड गिवन दैट इज व्हाट आई एम सेइंग आप ही दिया था एग्रीड मिश्रा जी आल्सो हैड गिवन नोटिस एंड ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ मिश्रा जी Kumari Mayabadi also raised this issue. From this side also Punia raised this issue. I know that. But then what I said is, I said very clearly that 267 notice is not admitted, rejected. However, if you want, give another notice. That is not 267 notice.
आपने कहा कि कल लाइए मैं आपको अलाउ
ना आई आल्सो सेड 267 इज रिजेक्टेड
नो
267 यू कैन गिव अनदर नोटिस इफ यू वांट
आई हैव गिवन अनदर नोटिस
नो फॉर श्योर शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन डिस्कशन के लिए नोटिस दे दो इफ आई डिड नॉट से यस्टरडे आई एम नाउ सेइंग यू गिव शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन नोटिस That can be examined, that can be considered, no problem. But no 267. No 267. No 267, I am not admitting. Yeah. 267, I am. Yes.
तो जिस विषय की चर्चा कल से चल रही है उसके संबंध में कुछ जानकारी दे दूं आप अनुमति दे तो आप अनुमति
आपने कल सुनो
सर सर
सी लेकिन
सदन के
मंत्री जी ने हिंदी में बोला अभी भी हिंदी में रेस कर दिया लेकिन मेरे को कुछ समझ में आया बात इतना है कि आपने रेस किया मंत्री ने अश्योरेंस दिया हो जाएगा अश्योरेंस दिया
मैं आज भी अभी कहना चाहता हूँ सर आप अनुमति दे दे मुझे
या?
जी
या?
मैं कुछ कहना चाहता हूँ
जो शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन का नोटिस दे दो राम गोपाल जी 267 इज नॉट एडमिटेड
आने का हमें आश्वासन दीजिए ये मंत्री जी कह रहे हैं चर्चा करा देंगे
मैंने बोला शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन स्टडी दिन यू गिव नोटिस
अरे
शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन आज
नहीं
शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन आपने दिया है
आज का है ये आज का
शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन के लिए दिया है 267 आई हैव रिजेक्टेड आई टोल्ड यू नो राम गोपाल जी नो नो राम गोपाल जी नो राम गोपाल जी मैंने पहले बोला 267 मैंने रिजेक्ट किया है इट इज रिजेक्टेड
बट
गिव अनदर नोटिस फॉर शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन व्हाट इज द पॉइंट ऑफ ऑर्डर दिग्विजय सिंह जी ऑन पॉइंट ऑफ ऑर्डर
मैं आपसे अनुरोध करता हूँ कि आपके कहने के बावजूद मेरा सब्सटेंटिव मोशन को एडमिट होने के बावजूद
दूसरी बात है
अभी तक माननीय आपके आदेशों के बावजूद सरकार के सदन के नेता से आपकी चर्चा नहीं हो पा रही है हम कब तक इंतजार करें कब तक इसका इंतजार करते रहे थोड़ा प्लीज टेक नोटिस ऑफ दिस हाउ लॉन्ग एवरी डे वी आर रेजिंग दिस इश्यू प्लीज आई सीक योर इंटेलिजेंस मैं आपसे वादा करता हूं माननीय सभापति महोदय कि आप
व्हाट इज यू वांट टू रिएक्ट ए मिस्टर मिनिस्टर
सर ऑनरेबल राम गोपाल यादव जी ने और ऑनरेबल माननीय सदस्यों ने जो एससी एसटी माइनॉरिटी कमीशन का मुद्दा उठाया है उसके बारे में थावरचंद गहलोत जी ने भी अभी जो फैक्चुअल स्थिति है वो भी कल मैंने भी बताई थी कि जब ये नियुक्तियां जो जो इसमें रिक्तियां हुई हैं, वैकेंसीज हुई हैं, वो जिस वक्त की आचार संहिता लगी हुई थी उस समय, एक मिनट चर्चा नहीं, तो फिर आप चाहते हैं कि आप ही बोलें और फिर तो उसको आप, मैं कोई चीज बताऊंगा तो थोड़ा सा सुन लीजिए ना, सिर्फ सुनेंगे नहीं,
सुनिए सुनिए।
तो सर जो माननीय राम गोपाल जी ने कहा है कि इस पर जो है वो इस मुद्दे पर चर्चा हो, इस मुद्दे पे चर्चा जो है विस्तार से, तो हम हर चीज का जवाब देने को तैयार है और उस पे जो संबंध में नियमों के तहत जो नोटिस देंगे और वो चेयर को तय करना है, चेयर तय करे, उसमें नियमों के तहत चर्चा होनी है, उसमें हम लोग जवाब देने को तैयार है।
चर्चा के लिए
कुछ माननीय सदस्यों ने कल कहा था कि मैं और ये मंत्री जी दोनों इस सदन को भ्रमित कर रहे हैं, उसका हम स्पष्टीकरण देना चाहते हैं, आप अनुमति प्रदान करें, मैं स्पष्टीकरण देना चाहता हूँ।
आप कल दिया है, आप कल किया है, आपने कल
मना कर,
नो सुनिए, नो मिनिस्टर हैज यस्टरडे एक्सप्लेन वेरी वेल एंड गिव अश्योरेंस, इट इज वेरी क्लियर, कल स्पष्टीकरण कल दिया है और बोलने की जरूरत नहीं है, इट इज ऑन रिकॉर्ड, इट इज ऑन रिकॉर्ड। नो राम गोपाल जी चर्चा के लिए
नोटिस कल आ जाएगा, आपको आश्वासन दीजिए हम लोगों को,
शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन, या ओके शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन डिस्कस कंसिडर करेगा, ओके या
अब आप पीछे हट जाइए,
हो गया।
एसटी ओबीसी और माइनॉरिटीज कमीशन का जो मामला है जिसको इन्होंने केंद्र की सरकार ने निष्प्रभावी बना दिया है पूरे तौर से,
वही इसके बारे में बोला डिस्कशन होने
है, आप गंभीरता से लीजिए और इसको अल्पकालीन चर्चा से काम नहीं चलेगा, सरकार को जवाब देना होगा, ठोस जवाब देना होगा,
हो
सरकार को बताना होगा कि ये जो कमीशन है तो इनको इन्होंने निष्प्रभावी क्यों बनाया हुआ है, अभी तक इनके पद खाली क्यों पड़े हुए हैं।
डिस्कशन के समय, डिस्कशन के समय आप रेस कर दीजिए, कोई बात या
सर, आई वांट
योर सब्सटेंडी मोशन, आई विल टेल यू द पोजीशन, ओके
प्रोसीजर,
सब्सटेंडी मोशन,
वी नो द प्रोसीजर,
आई विल टेल यू द पोजीशन, आई सेड आई विल टेल यू द पोजीशन,
पोजीशन
I tell you the position.
So please do, sir. Number one.
Yes. By
give your ruling, sir.
Yeah, that is what I... See? Now, see? On another... No, let me dispose of this.
Discuss Tamil Nadu farmers.
I am coming to you. Yes. Sir, you will be given chance.
Yes, we are given notice.
I will call you. Sit down. I will call you. Are ho jayega. Sit down. I will tell you. Sit down. I will call you. Sit down. Sit down. Now, see, with regard to what Mr. Digvijay Singh has raised, you see, yes... Your notice is there. Honorable Chairman has admitted that. And the next is, it is for the government, the leader of the house, to give the time for the discussion. And we are waiting for that. And once the time is, time and date. Yeah. No. Government, yeah.
That they have to discuss this.
Yeah. So.
They have to give a date.
Yeah. We are expecting that. They're coming. All right. Now, that's okay. All others, now please. I know, that is first with me. I know it, you don't worry. I know it, it is before me. Yeah, no, I know. It is before me, don't worry. I don't need recommendation. No. Yeah. Now, okay. No, I already said the government is to give time. I made it very clear. Yeah, I have made my point clear, my position clear. Now, yeah, what is your point? Yeah, yes.
Sir.
No, Budhaniya, sit down.
Sir.
You are not given notice, sir. Sit down. No, sit down, you are not given notice. You are not given, Budhaniya, have notice in India.
बगल के कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी में जा रहे हैं, लिट्टीपाड़ा और साहबगंज जहां प्रधानमंत्री जा रहे हैं, दोनों एक ही लोकसभा का कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी है, और
तो इसलिए क्या है
ये बात कहा जा रहा है कि वहां से लोगों को वहां पर
लाया
जाए,
सर शरद पवार,
response, Prime Minister.
No,
response,
no, don't allow, don't allow.
What's going on? This Sharad type Pawar of briefing statement is not acceptable.
No, yeah, not allowed. Sri Sharad Pawar ji. Sharad Pawar. No, please. Sri Sharad Pawar ji. Ab log baithiye. Baithiye, baithiye. Baithiye, baithiye. I have called Sri Sharad Pawar ji. No, sit down. No, no, no. You are not given notice. Budhaniya ji, you have not given notice. Sit down. No, without. No, no. You are not given notice. No, sit down. Sit down. No, no, you can't do that. No, sit down, sit down. No, no, sit down. Are you biting? Ramchandra Bhattacharya, sit down. Nothing else will go on record. Nothing else will go on record. Only what Sharad Pawar ji says. Sharad Pawar ji. No, sit down. Ramchandra Rao, sit down. Honorable Sharad Pawar ji.
Deputy Chairman, sir. I would like to raise one of the important issues, that is the effect of the cancellation of currency notes on the District Central Cooperative Banks of India and its effect on the agriculture credit, particularly to rabi crop in throughout India. Department of Economic Affairs notified the cancellation of ₹501,000 bank notes from the monetary system called specified bank notes. On 8th of November 2016, following this notification, the District Central Cooperative Banks were not allowed to accept deposit of specified bank notes or exchange them for the new currency. District Central Cooperative Banks were allowed to accept deposit or SBNs or exchange through conclusion dated 9th of November 2016 and again 14th of November 2016 District Central Cooperative Bank was restrained from accepting or exchanging the currency. Thus, District Central Cooperative Bank received deposits of currency from 10th of November 2016 to 13th of November 2016. Between this period, throughout India, 371 District Central Cooperative Banks received deposit worth ₹44,000 crores. I haven't got the detailed report about other states, but I got report of my own state. 31 District Central Cooperative Banks in the state of Maharashtra secured ₹4,600 crores as a deposit. However, on 17th of November 2016, Reserve Bank issued a guideline to currency test banks restricting them from accepting this currency from District Central Cooperative Banks. Subsequently, the District Central Cooperative Bank accumulated this currency and advised to retain with them till further instruction from RBI. As a result, on 17th of November 2016, District Central Cooperative Bank in India was still holding currency of more than 8,000 crores and the Cooperative Bank in the Maharashtra is holding ₹2,772 crores. In addition to restricting currency test of receiving SBN from the District Central Cooperative Bank, banks were also informed that currency cannot form part of the bank cash balances. The SBN cannot be part of cash balances of the bank from close of business as on December 31, 2016. The accumulated currency notes having detrimental impact on the financial health of the District Central Cooperative Bank because the currency cannot form part of the cash balance they are lying as a non-entering asset, as they are not considering.
Why are you troubling? Why are you troubling? Why are you troubling?
As they are not considered part of the cash balances, the accumulated currency are not included while calculating the cash reserve requirement under the cash reserve ratio. The district central cooperative bank are also
Okay, now it may continue to be recorded. Yes, it is being recorded.
District central cooperative bank are also obliged to pay interest at least 4% on the deposit made between 10th and 13th of November. Further, few of the deposits are being converted into term loans, so they have to pay higher interest. In spite of the many notifications in this regard, Reserve Bank, the currency shares bank, has not made available to the bank notes in District Central Cooperative Bank. This has a great impact on the rabi season crop loan disbursement. The state of Maharashtra target of the rabi season was 13,500 crores and achievement till date is 4,000 crores, means 33% only. And target of the rabi season in the Maharashtra was 4,400 crores, but the achievement is 1,000 crores, means 22%. That means farmers are not getting crop loan. That is the overall situation. So money is lying in the bank. Other banks are not accepting. Reserve Bank is not accepting. They have to pay interest, they have to pay insurance, and money is not available for agriculture operation. It is a serious thing. And this issue was raised to the Reserve Bank of India by Mr. Dilip Sanghani, happened to be a national president of the Cooperative Bank Federation. He was a minister on Gujarat government under Narendra Modi ji. He himself has written to Arun Jaitley ji. He has written to Reserve Bank. I have written to Prime Minister. I have written to Finance Minister. Throughout India, all district banks, cooperative banks, are keeping that money and they are not in position to use, and that money is not available for me. It is affecting agriculture season.
All are supporting. Minister is reacting.
Finance bill, let him respond to this matter. It's a serious.
At that time, you can
cannot
raise.
Be.
At that time, you can raise.
We are requesting.
Yeah.
This is a very serious matter that has.
Yeah,
been
at that point of time, you can raise.
No, not at that point. This should be.
When the finance.
The government must agree.
Yeah.
Sir, yehi nahi hai. Sir,
yehi nahi. Anyhow, finance minister is coming here today at 2 p.m. Now, listen. No need of. No, please. Honorable Finance Minister will be here at 2 p.m. and we will have discussion on finance bill. You can raise at that point of time. Yeah. And also, Minister has assured it will be examined. Now, please say, there is no need. Honorable Finance Minister will be here at 2 p.m. At that point of time, any member who speaks can rake up this issue and no problem. Now. The end, I know from this side everybody stood up. I know that. I have noticed that. All those whose name may be added. And the minister also supported. Minister said it will be taken. Yeah. Minister also did not oppose it. Nakviji, sir. No point. No problem. Now, Tiruchi Shiva, your 267 is converted into 0 hour.
Sir.
So you can.
Sir, thank
only
you.
Only 0 hour time for it.
Sir. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Deputy Chairman, sir. Come. Sir, he's taking my time, sir. Kindly reset the clock, please.
Digvijay, you raise.
Kindly reset the clock.
Yeah, please.
Kindly reset the clock.
Yeah.
Sir, despite being an agricultural country, sir, the woes and miseries of our farmers are increasing day by day. Sir, the state of Tamil Nadu has been declared as a drought-hit state, sir. And the farmers are agitating in Tamil Nadu as well as in Jandar Mandar for the past 15 days and for the past 2 months in Tamil Nadu. Sir, 200 farmers have committed suicide and the demands are very simple, that the loans that they have secured from the banks have to be waived, number one, sir. And second, the state government has requested for a assistance of rupees 40,000 crore from the NDRF fund, whereas the high-level committee has recommended and the government has sanctioned only 1,804 towards drought relief fund, which is a peanut to the requirement there, sir. Moreover, there is not even a single paisa has been given as compensation for the loss of production in the areas that have already been sown. Sir, it is very, very serious condition, sir. The finance minister gave graciously an audience yesterday to the farmers. He gave some explanations. It was consoling, sir, but no solution is brought. Sir, what we request is constitution of Kaveri Management Board and linking of rivers are very essential. Apart from that, waiver of loans is the foremost, and the banks are taking very stringent actions, strangling the already suffering farmers to repay the loans which they have already got. So instructions have to be given by the government to the banks that the farmers should not be squeezed to repay the loan. And we have also requested two other things, that around 15.1 lakh farmers have insured 31 lakh of acres for 8,878 crore rupees, sir. Sir, the government can give instructions to the insurance companies to immediately disperse the insured amounts. That at least will help some farmers there, sir. So foremost of all, there is another program by the central government, AIBP, Accelerated Integrated Benefit Program, sir. And it is extended as a loan assistance to the states, which the states cannot implement by the available resources available with the state, sir. So I request the government to release adequate funds from the AIBP and to give instructions to the insurance companies to immediately disperse the amount and to waive the loans which the farmers have already got from the banks, and the banks should be instructed that they should not strangling already the suffering farmers, sir. Thank you very much.
Sri D. Raja, to associate. D. Raja, I know he has given notice.
Sir,
I will allow you also.
Sir, my notice is
D. Raja's there. Notice is there.
My notice is there.
D. Raja, notice is there. After that, Rangarajan, then only. Because Rangarajan notice also there.
Sir, two minutes.
Sir, I give you 2 minutes, bolo.
Sir, my notice is 267, sir.
Bolo.
Okay. Sir, I draw the attention of the entire house and the government. Agriculture in the country is in deep crisis. The farmers are passing through unprecedented distress. The plight of Tamil Nadu farmers is miserable, sir. Tamil Nadu farmers have come to Jantar Mantar. They are agitating for more than 2 weeks. And they have met the president, they have met the finance minister, they have met the agriculture minister, and several MPs have met them. But their plight continues. They are asking for loan waiver. I make a concrete proposal to the government. Government can take a stand on loan waiver for the farmers. You are taking decisions for loan waiver for many other sections. But here, in the case of farmers, the central government, the union government, can take a categorical position for giving loan waiver to the farmers. And it will help Tamil Nadu farmers also, number one. Number two, there is a project which is called hydrocarbon project. And recently, the petroleum ministry has signed MOUs with the private companies. And the farmers are agitating in Pudukkottai district of Tamil Nadu. They are afraid that groundwater level will go down and it will lead to depletion of groundwater. And it will affect further the agriculture. Union government here also, it is an issue before the union government. Union government can assure the Tamil Nadu farmers that government of India will not implement the hydrocarbon project unless it's accepted by
Tamil Nadu farmers.
Why you are forcing...
Okay, our time over. Time over. Rangarajan. Rangarajan, take 2 minutes.
Thank you, sir. The Tamil Nadu farmers, they are facing a very grave situation. This situation was there 140 years back. Today, 15th day, some farmers are agitating here. Some Gurudwaras helping. Delhi people, Tamils are helping. But unfortunately, the Home Ministry, the police, they are threatening them. They ask them to vacate. I request the Home Ministry, don't do that. It's a purely genuine struggle against the relief for the, they have come. Why police intervene them? Please, I ask the Home Minister, don't do that. Because that area has been allowed by the Parliament to do agitations. Next, the demand is very junior. BBC is broadcasting it. Lakhs of people are seeing that. The Tamil Nadu, there is no drinking water. There is no feed for cattle. This situation should not continue. Though Finance Minister, we also met, Sitaram met, I met, and their representatives of farmers also met. But the point is, there is no result. There must be result. Otherwise, the entire Tamil Nadu will agitate against the centre. The centre should help the Tamil Nadu. This is the time. Please, loan waiver is the must. And water is should be supplied for drinking. There must be a war footing arrangement by the centre. Otherwise, things will go to the bad to worse.
Thank you very much. Yes. HRT associate.
Sir, I...
Yeah, now I need associate.
Sir,
only associate.
One minute. Sir, I met these farmers here when they were here under protested gentleman. I have, sir, unfortunately the country is used to a farmer suicides. We know the situation, but what I have seen with them, with live rats, they were saying this is the only food we have. That is what they were eating. This is the state of India, sir, today. When our annadatas are forced to eat mice and rats, saying that there is no way they can survive otherwise. Sir, please ask this government through you. I'm appealing. You can waive the NPAs for rich corporates, but you can't waive loans for these poor farmers who are committing suicide. This is something that is not acceptable. And it's only a fraction of what you're waiving to the rich people. You waive this and save our annadata, save Indian agriculture and Indian farmers. Otherwise, there's no future for my country, sir.
Okay,
sir, this is a very serious matter. Please take cognizance.
I actually saw a photograph in the one of the newspapers. I saw a photograph of a farmer eating
very sad.
Yeah,
very,
yeah,
very
rat sad. In the mouth. I think government should talk to the... See, that Dharmalaji. Have a dialogue with this. Nirmala Sitharaman. Government, I hope we'll have a talk with them.
Sir, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to respond on a very sensitive issue, which several honorable members have raised. I wish to put on record some of the responses. The government is absolutely sensitive and seized of the matter. Several honorable members have taken appointments with ministers, as member D. Raja and also Trichy Shivaji mentioned. The finance minister has met the delegation of the farmers who are protesting. Agriculture Minister Radhamohan ji has met with them. So has Uma Bharti ji. There are several issues which are being together, and rightly together, being put in this matter, and all of which are being given separate attention. Like on agriculture and the irrigation related and insurance related matters. Crops sown which are not getting insurance cover is being taken up very seriously, because the Pradhan Mantri Sinchai Yojana clearly covers for sown in the field and loss, just after sowing loss, post-harvest loss, and even after harvest loss. So,
please listen to this.
There are several aspects to the insurance. In fact, let me put on record that when I went on a particular Digi Dhan Mela visit to Madurai, I have sat with the district magistrate, the collector, and looked at the coverage of insurance for farmers. There are issues, I admit. There are issues about coverage. There are issues about farmers not getting included in the scheme, although they are deserving of it. So on the insurance, definitely agriculture minister and the government is together working to see how best the coverage can be given. That is one thing about the farmer insurance on which issues have been raised. On Kaveri Water Management Board, which has repeatedly been raised also, the government is working. Uma Bharti ji is fully seized of the matter. We are responding to that. Again, talking about Neduvasan, I have myself been a part of the ministry together with Dharmendra Pradhanji and Pon Radhakrishnan, who is a minister, also from elected from Tamil Nadu, with the delegation which came from Pudukkottai to talk about it, as to what concerns those people have about their land, the prospects of agriculture in future, what is hydrocarbon exploration going to do, and all this has been completely discussed. Minister Dharmendra Pradhan has assured that the team will go and talk to the affected people and take their concerns before anything happens. The MOU signing has been absolutely explained. It is a commercial contract. To find out who has the qualification to do it, it is only a memorandum of understanding, after which the state government also has various steps to take before the actual activity commences. So to think that this is already violative of what the minister has committed to the people who came and met them is absolutely not with basis. I would like to assure the member that this concern about hydrocarbon Neduvasil has been in detail spoken by the minister, and since many issues are getting included in this, I would seek your permission, which you've granted me, to address, to let know the members whether it is Neduvasil, whether it is the insurance coverage, or whether it is farming related problem. And of course, not taking more of your time, I have a complete list of how much has been released by Government of India for Tamil Nadu. There has not been a denial of what has to be given. In fact, just one point I would like to draw your attention. In 2015-16, SDRF, NDRF, the National Disaster Relief monies which have to go to Tamil Nadu, 1,000 crores have been released as against the allocation under SDRF. So I need to assure those members. Agreed. Sir.
Okay.
We are not certainly getting into a discussion on it.
No, Rangarajan, please don't interrupt.
The point that I want to give here in front of all the members is the Government of India has been seeing all the delegation, whether it is of Neduvasil or for the farmers' agitation. And I would like the people of Tamil Nadu, and I'd like to...
Okay, that's enough.
Through the issues which have been raised by the honorable members, clear. That Tamil Nadu is getting the due recognition and issues
have
been addressed
by us. That's enough. No more question. Sit down. Not permitted. Pavan Kumar, not permitted, sit down. I have only a suggestion, I have only a request that the honourable members who have taken up it, along with the honourable minister, should convince these members, farmers who are agitating, so that they will wind up, they will close their agitation. That is the point. Now, please. Sri Vivek Gupta. Now, whatever she can say, she said. Non-waiver is another question. So, Vivek Gupta. No, she's... That the finance minister can only say. No.
Asking us to please the farmers to go back will succeed only the moment the government announces the loan waiver.
I told government also should cooperate.
Let them announce the loan waiver, they'll go back.
That anyhow, finance minister has to take a decision.
So
she cannot.
Tell them to do it, sir.
Sit down. Bite. No, that's okay. She cannot say more than this. The finance.
कर्जा माफी जो सबसे बड़ा मुद्दा है, सबसे ज्यादा तमिलनाडु में
कितना फर्स्ट इशू है,
उसमें तो कुछ बोले नहीं,
जो नो नरेश जी सी नो प्लीज सी नो नो यू सिट डाउन नो सी ऑनरेबल मेंबर्स यू नो सी फॉर लॉन वेवर. Do you think that a minister can stand up and say that loan waiver is sanctioned? How can it be? It is when the finance minister comes, I can tell you at 2 p.m. when you take up the finance bill, I will allow one of you to raise this issue. Not now, sit down. Not now, not is over. Now Vivek Gupta, Sri Vivek Gupta. No, 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 you can ask that question, then he will give you a reply. No, 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 you can ask the question. Sri Vivek Gupta, you can ask the finance minister, not this minister. She did whatever she can. To the extent she can, she gave an answer. Yes, Vivek Gupta.
Sir.
Sri Vivek Gupta.
Sir, recently.
Neeraj Chagar, sit down. Vivek Gupta, Vivek Gupta. That's not going on record. Vivek Gupta.
Sir, recently, the US...
Nothing else will go on record. Vivek Gupta.
Sir, recently the US and UK airports have banned...
Chagar, Neeraj Chagar, sit down.
Sir, recently the US...
Bolo, bolo. Sir, you speak. You speak, it is on record.
US and UK airports have banned all electronic items larger than mobile phones like tablets, laptops and DVD players from taking into the cabin of the plane. Sir, through you I would request that our country also reviews these arrangements because we are also under high amount of terrorist threat. But sir, the larger issue out here is every day there are different guidelines being issued by different airlines. So some airlines says you can take a tablet inside, some says you have to check in a tablet. Sir, there is no uniform guidelines being issued by the Ministry of Civil Aviation. And the airlines are being given, there is so much of confusion at the airport. You go in, and when you are going for a security check, then you are supposed to go back again, check in the luggage. Sir, there is utter chaos at the airport. Sir, through you, I would wish to bring your attention to the Honorable Government and the Minister of Civil Aviation. Look into this problem urgently. Sir, the bigger problem is that we lack around 2,500 CISF staff according to various reports, which have made our airports more vulnerable. Sir, 26 hypersensitive airports are still not covered by CISF and we don't know who's handling the security. Sir, various travel advisories are issued by other countries, but we seem to be lacking behind it. Sir, whenever there is a ban issued, I would like the government to issue a centralized ban so that there is no confusion to the passengers and they can easily go to the airport. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Sri Pramod Tiwari.
Uttar Pradesh ke ek badi abadi ke logon ki
yes, can be ordered.
Jan bhavana ko uthane ke liye khada hua hu. Manavar 2001 ki janagarna ke ansar lagbhag 3 crore se adhik Uttar Bharatiyon ki मूल भाषा अवधी है. ये उत्तर प्रदेश में, बगल में कुछ हिस्सों में बिहार में, मध्य प्रदेश में, झारखंड में बोली जाती है. मैं ये भी कहना चाहता हूं, बंबई के भी एक बहुत अवधी भाषी वहां रहते हैं, पर इसमें बड़ी बड़ी रचनाएं हुई हैं, कालजयी रचनाएं हुई हैं जो अनाद काल से चली आ रही हैं और चलती रहेंगी, जिसमें तुलसीदास की रामचरितमानस, हनुमान चालीसा और रसखान जैसे कवि ने भी अवधी भाषा में लिखा है. और इसी भाषा के आधार पर एक अवध प्रांत की स्थापना भी हुई थी जो उत्तर प्रदेश के एक बहुत बड़े हिस्से में फैला हुआ है. इसमें बहुत ही बड़ा साहित्य भी है, भाषा भी पूरी तरीके से अपने आप में मजबूत है, उसका व्याकरण भी है. सभी कुछ होते हुए भी इस पर हम नहीं देख पा रहे हैं कि उसको कोई संरक्षण मिल रहा है. इसलिए धीरे धीरे इस भाषा को, जो इसका आधार मिलना चाहिए था, नहीं मिल पाया. एक बड़े भूभाग में करोड़ों लोगों की मांग ये है कि इसको भारत के संविधान की 8वीं अनुसूची में दर्ज किया जाए और इसे संवैधानिक दर्जा दिया जाए. मैं आपसे कहना चाहता हूं कि जहां तक अवधि का सवाल है, मानवर सामने बैठे लोग ये अवधि के जो नायक हैं, उनका उपयोग तो करते हैं, उनका उपयोग जरूर करेंगे. अवधि भाषा के रामचरितमानस में लिखी गई नायक का करते हैं, लेकिन ये कभी भी उसका प्रमोशन नहीं करते. मैं एक बात कह के अपनी बात समाप्त करूंगा. अवधि भाषा बहुत अच्छी भाषा है. हम यही चाहिए थी कि अवधि भाषा का भारत के संविधान के 8वीं सूची में दर्ज हो जाए. यही लिए हम अपन बात कहे खातिर यहाँ पे खड़ा भाई. और हम कह सकी थी कि अवधि भाषा, आप हिंदी समझ पाए न समझ पाए, कोई भाषा समझ पाए न समझ पाए, डिप्टी चेयरमैन सर, अवधि भाषा आप जरूर समझ जाएंगे. ये बहुत प्यारी, वही तो बोलत है, और क्या बोलत है इतनी देर से, वही तो बोलत है इतनी देर से. मैं सिर्फ कहना चाहता हूँ, अवधि अवधी भाषा को भारत के संविधान के 8वीं सूची में दर्ज हो, यही खातिर हम यहाँ पे फरियाद करे खातिर खड़ा भाई। हम चाहे थे अवधी भाषा का भारत के संविधान के 8वीं सूची में दर्ज की जाए।
ओके, थैंक यू। ऑल द नेम्स में बी एडेड। श्रीमती वंदना चौहान, श्रीमती वंदना चौहान, नीरज शेखर श्रीराम, नीरज शेखर श्रीराम, श्रीमती वंदना चौहान, स्टार्ट प्लीज।
I wish to draw the attention of the government, sir, to a major health issue to which especially the young generation of our country is falling prey, sir. This house has been voicing concern about drugs since several times, but it has been increasingly seen recently that use of synthetic drugs has increased considerably in comparison to the natural drugs amongst the young generation of India. Synthetic drugs are cheaper, making it more affordable to the youth, and worse still, they are more hazardous and addictive to the consumers. Sir, today Punjab, followed by Maharashtra, leads the market in smuggling, production and consumption of synthetic drugs. Sir, recently in Maharashtra, the Directorate of Revenue Intelligence and Narcotics Control Bureau busted an international drug racket from Palghar Taluka, seizing 238 kilos of mephedrone and 8.2 kilos of hashish. This is not the first time, sir, that this happened in Maharashtra. Even in 2014 and 2015, mephedrone worth 1.2 lakhs per year was being seized. Sir, today this has increased to 10 crores per year, sir. So this has been increasing consistently every year. So Mumbai crime branch alone registered 114 cases of drug possession in 2016, which constituted 1.86 crore worth, sir, and 50% of it consists of synthetic drugs. So we need to look not only at the consumption but also the consequences. Today the National Crime Bureau records, sir, show that there were 3,647 drug related suicides in 2014, of which Maharashtra faced the highest, that is 1,372. Therefore, sir, the picture is all over in our country almost the same. Latest data from the Narcotics Control Bureau also, sir, shows that smuggling and consumption of synthetic drugs has become more and more dangerous, addictive and injurious to health and than the natural ones. Sir, I wish to also bring to light the some of the record of the Childline India, which says that it has become more and more accessible to youngsters. An NGO survey in India revealed that 63.6% of patients coming in for drug rehabilitation treatment were introduced to drugs below the age of 15 years, sir. So this is a very serious issue. Not only this drug is injected, and so it also throws open the youngsters to HIV. I wish to bring the to the attention of the government that concrete steps must be taken in this direction.
Yes, it's a all support. I think the entire house will support. It's a serious issue. I don't know what the government can do, but the government should seriously.
Yes, it's a very serious issue.
Yeah.
And definitely I will inform
you. Sri Ananda Bhaskar Rapalu. Ananda Bhaskar Rapalu.
Targeted for this.
Sri Ananda Bhaskar Rapalu.
Time be set to. Respected Deputy Chairman, like the multi-drug resistant tuberculosis, my subject is hanging since March 24, the World Tuberculosis Day, for its submission. I stand here to bring to the attention of the Union Government about the necessity of the safe medicines and the advanced vaccine to tackle the dreaded tuberculosis. Tuberculosis in our country is a passive killer, but killing above 5 lakh people every year, from which 1 lakh people are due to multi-drug resistant tuberculosis. Tuberculosis is of infectious and non-infectious category, which is non-infectious tuberculosis. It is having the problem with the brains, bones, marrow, spine and abdomen, and which is causing the fatal situation to the patient. But three varieties of serious antibiotics had to be administered, and after the medication, even after the long medication, if they come out of the danger, they are not able to perform their daily chores to cater to their livelihood. This has given a dangerous situation due to the growing pollution conditions and the global warming. We are yet to include into the fever investigations the skin test, which is the Montaux test, which will very easily detect the primary stage of the tuberculosis with which we can prevent. We are not having the protocols to cater to the patients who are affected with the tuberculosis, and I urge upon the union government to look at the possibility of providing the nutritious food under Antyodaya, under the Food Security Act, to those who are affected with the tuberculosis. And with the advanced stage of the tuberculosis, it is giving the infection spreading across and affecting the communities and the societies of the lower and lowest level income groups. So I urge upon union government to give the prevention of the tuberculosis, and the necessity of the advanced vaccine is highly required. 135 years ago, Dr. Robert Koch has detected on March 24 in 1882, but so far we could not develop an advanced vaccine. We are having only BCG for the newborn children. So advanced vaccine will prevent the complication, for which there is every necessity to support huge funds to the research organizations with which we can come out with a vaccine. Thank you very much.
Yes, K.K. Ragesh. K.K. Ragesh, yes, all the names will be added. Ragesh, you start, please. K.K. Ragesh, you start.
Thank you, sir. Sir, I take this opportunity to bring before this august house regarding the blatant privatization that is being unleashed by the central government of the private public sector units of our country on the basis of the recommendation of the Niti Aayog. Sir, while inaugurating the Bakranagal Dam, Jawaharlal Nehru depicted the public sector units of our country as the temples of modern India. But now, the government, the people who are always talking about temples, are simply selling out all those temples which was depicted by Jawaharlal Nehru, the temples of our modern India. Sir, in Kerala, in the industrial map of our country, Kerala has a very, very insignificant place so far as the share of public sector undertakings of our country are concerned. And now the government had decided, the central government had decided on the recommendation of the Niti Aayog to privatize, sell out, to divest many of those few public sector, all of those public sector industries in the state of Kerala. Sir, what is the logic of getting it privatized? Sir, BML, which is a profit-making company, which has got a strategic importance as it produces defense equipment, it is, its 26% of its share is decided to be privatized, and with management control, if you spend 1,000 crores of rupees, you can get the management control of a company which worth 56,000 crores of rupees. Sir, what is this? Is it the patriotism that you are talking about? Is it on the interest of the of our country? It is nothing but the betrayal of the people and the nation of itself, sir. Sir, the Hindustan Newsprint, which is also a subsidiary of HPC, it is also decided to be sold out. And sir, it had already paid 117 crores of rupees as dividend. Now that company is facing some crisis due to your import policies, and there is a proposal for modernization. Proposal is pending before the government, but the government is not ready to accept that proposal, and I am demanding to provide necessary grant and revamp that company instead of privatizing that company. Sir, same is the case with BHEL, EML, Kasaragod also. Niti Aayog had recommended to privatize EML also. Government is asked to take back that company, state government. State government is not doing that. And now Niti Aayog is going for privatization. Sir, same is the case with FACT also. Same is the case with
Subbaram Reddy. Yes, all the names will be added. Subbaram Reddy, Subbaram Reddy, start, start. You start. Subbaram Reddy, you start. Subbaram Reddy, you start.
please.
Subbaram Reddy, you please start. No, you start, Subbaram Reddy. It will go on, it will be on record. You start. It will be on record.
Sir, this is a very serious matter. Actually, the fake currency notes being circulated in the country. It's very surprising is how the people are able to gain the printing machine in such a way that they can give the perfect printing, actually fake notes. This is very challenge for the before the actually Home Ministry and also National Investigation Agency. The main reasons announced by Honorable Prime Minister for demonstration effect affected in October 2016 are actually bringing about black money, eradication of fake currency notes and curbing terror financing. But however, within few weeks of announcement, fake currency notes of high value have started surfacing in the market. Smuggling and pushing fake currency, high value notes from across the Indo-Bangladesh border is of such a large quantity that it has been handed over to the National Investigation Agency for further actually deep probe. While fake notes found in some parts of the country in the beginning were photocopied versions, the counterfeit seized at the Indo-Bangladesh had most of the security features like Gandhi Waterman mark next to the national emblem, but a fake currency, as we said. So RBI Reserve Bank officials reportedly admit that adding additional security features in a new high-value currency requires a mammoth exercise and needs several rounds of consultation. So there was no time to introduce additional security features in the new currency notes of 2,500. Sir, there has been around half dozen cases where fake currency notes in the denomination of 2,000 were recovered. A case was registered recently in Mohali near Chandigarh where 2,000 currency notes with a face value of 42 lakhs was recovered. When West Bengal police registered another case following recovered made by BSF as Indo-Bangladesh border. The latest seizures were made on the February 8th in Munshiabad from two suspects who were carrying fake notes 2,000 denomination. According to source, a study by the investigation experts of seized notes revealed that at least seven of the security features in the new 2,000 notes had been replicated. They included transparent area, watermark, Ashoka pillars, emblem, etc. Although the print and proper quality of seized counterfeits were poor, they resembled genuine notes. By said, it is difficult to detect the fake notes even by the bankers also. When the naked eye, it's a very serious matter. I demand that the government and Reserve Bank of India and Home Ministry must take all pains care to address the issue of counterfeit notes of high value pushed by smugglers through porous Indo-Bangladesh border and introduce additional security features to safeguard the country. This is such a serious matter. If it is not controlled, it may destabilize the Indian economy also.
एक बार सुबिरा मेरा टाइम निकल जाएगा तीन बार से दे रहा हूँ वहाँ पे recently the government has announced the national health policy the target of the increasing health expenditure to 2.5% of GDP by 2025 सर ये जो national health policy announced हुई है इसमें 2017 की इसमें सिर्फ 2.5% का growth उन्होंने 2025 तक दिया मरीज जो है वो 90% मरीजों की जेब से खर्चा जाता है सरकारी अस्पतालों का बुला हाल है हमारा कहना है कि और 65 million लोग बीमा इसकी वजह से बेरोजगारी poverty line से नीचे जा रहे हैं national health policy को सरकार को फिर से दुरुस्त करना चाहिए और उसमें expenditure क्योंकि बांग्लादेश और पाकिस्तान के बाद सिर्फ भारत आता है श्रीलंका और चाइना का हमसे बहुत ज्यादा है नेशनल हेल्थ पॉलिसी पे जो नेशनल हेल्थ एक्सपेंडिचर है तो मेरा सरकार से यही कहना है कि जो नेशनल हेल्थ एक्सपेंडिचर है 2.5% से कुछ नहीं होगा मिनिमम 3.5% या 4% करना चाहिए वरना यहाँ पे 65 मिलियन गरीब जो है हर बार जो है पावर्टी लाइन के नीचे जाएंगे उनका सरकारी अस्पतालों में इलाज हो नहीं पाएगा प्राइवेट अस्पतालों में बहुत महंगा इलाज होता है तो इसलिए जो है नेशनल हेल्थ पॉलिसी में सुधार करके स्वास्थ्य मंत्री को और किसी तरह जो है इसको बजट को बढ़ाना चाहिए यही मेरी सरकार से मांग है
Yes, all the names who, yes, all the names will be ordered. Have you got a special mention? Okay. You stopped before 3 minutes, so that is my problem. Okay, what is your problem? Oh, no, I allowed you, already allowed you, sit down. That's over, sit down. Yes, Hussain Dalwai, what was your problem?
1 minute.
No. I allowed him earlier.
One minute, sir.
What is Hussain Dalwai's
problem? As per the World Health
As per World Health Organization study, India features among the countries with high out-of-pocket expenditure, where 89.2% of the expenses of medical treatment is borne by the patient. In our country, high out-of-pocket expenditure.